Thrissur Pooram, the festival of festivals held in Thrissur. Thrissur is a small town in a northern district of Kerala. In and around Thrissur, there are many places of historic importance and of tourist interest. Cheraman Juma Masjid at Kodungallur, built by the first Islamic missionary to Kerala, Malik ibn Dinar, in 629 AD, is believed to be the first mosque in the Indian subcontinent. The first church on the Indian subcontinent, believed to be built by the Apostle Saint Thomas, is also in Kodungallur. The Shaktan Tamburan Palace in Thrissur town is a classic example of Kerala architecture. A veritable treasure trove of historic artifacts, the splendid facades of this monument attract hordes of visitors to this place every year. Kerala Kalamandalam, the internationally acclaimed centre of excellence for the classical performing arts of Kerala, is also situated near Thrissur. Another popular tourist spot is Punnattur Kota. With over 60 elephants, this is one of the largest centers of domesticated elephants in the world today. The elephants, placed before the deity of Guruvayur temple as ritual offering, are housed and reared here. Pooram literally means a congregation. Folklore has it that every year the deities of the neighboring hamlets meet at the Vadakkunnada temple. On that day, the heavenly hosts bring the heavens down on earth, drowning the land and the skies in joyful tumult. The festival begins with a ritualistic unfurling of the temple flag. Ten temples participate in the event. It was Raja Ramavarma, popularly known as Shaktan Tamburan, the Maharaja of the erstwhile state of Kochi, who initiated the grand tradition of Pooram 2 centuries ago. Various kinds of elephant decor give the Pooram its brilliant hues. Intricate work on the muttukudas, the glossy umbrellas, the nittipattam, the spectacular head ornament, and other ornaments start months before D-Day. All arrangements for the mesmerizing firework show, which is another major attraction of the Pooram, also start well ahead. Exhibitions lend a touch of extra glitter to the ever so mesmerizing Pooram colors. The enchanting elephant decor exhibition is a rare one of its kind, and draws hordes of visitors every year. For the town of Thrissur, the sleepless nights start even before the Puram. A day or two before the celebrations, elephant lovers start pouring into the town to feast their eyes on the pachyderms in the beautifully illuminated surroundings. The dawn of Puram Day. This is the Thiruvambadi temple. At 7 in the morning, the sub-deity, goddess Yogamaya Devi, starts her journey to the Vadakkunnatha temple. Devotees who line the streets make ritualistic offerings to the gods in their journey. Eight other deities from temples in the vicinity also set out to the Vadakkunnatha temple. These are the mini Purams with elephant regalia and orchestrations. Confluence of all the mini Purams from each temple thus becomes a virtual feast for the eyes and a symphony celestial for the ears. The procession from the Tiruvambadi temple stops at the Brahmaswam Madam for certain rituals. From there, in accompaniment to the sublime beat of the Panchavadyam, the procession moves on to the Vadakkunnatha temple. This to the Vadakkunnatha temple. Once the god finery. This is the Ilangi Theramelam, so called because it takes place under an Ilangi tree. The performance is meant as ritual offering of welcome for the goddess Paramekkava Bhagavati on her annual visit to the Vadakkunnatha temple. The performance of Pandi Melam, one of Kerala's native orchestras, is by well-known Melam performers, many of them maestros of their respective art forms. The Ilangi Theramelam is one of the central attractions of the Puram. Tekkottirakkam. From the South Gopuram, the procession from Paramekkava emerges, followed by the one from Tiruvambadi. Thank you. The latter takes up position on the Gopuram side, while the former is stationed on the opposite end of the Puram ground. The most captivating sight of the Puram is the competition of changing the display of decorative umbrellas. On either side of the ground, amidst the milling, enthralled crowds and the rhapsody of the drums, the goddesses from Tiruvambadi and Paramekava take up their stand atop rows of majestic elephants. Intricately crafted decorative umbrellas lend the evening its rainbow hues. With great pomp and cheer from each group, the umbrellas are changed in festive glory and vigor. The mounting enthusiasm of the audience is echoed in the rising crescendo of the drums. The bewitching fireworks show marks the grand finale of the Puram and is a fitting tribute to its sublime harmony of sight and sound. The day after the Puram is staged the Pagal Puram, a recap of the Puram's highlights and hallmarks. What took place the previous day in enigmatic twilight can now be enjoyed in broad daylight. This is the last chance of the year to savor the Puram delights. The goddesses bid adieu and begin the journey back to their abodes. All who bore witness to the festive ceremonies joined together to share a humble ritualistic meal, the Pura Kanyi. The curtain falls, and they wait, mortals and immortals alike, for another joyful year and the promise of another sumptuous Puram.